Everybody, if you like video game live streams and cool people that play video games, then I suggest you check out Erin Plays on YouTube, and also check out her second YouTube channel, Erin Plays Extras, as well. That's Erin Plays and Erin Plays Extras on YouTube. Check out her videos, they're really awesome. Hey everybody, it's me, Timmy Flyersguy, and boy, do I really miss Wings Lacrosse. Remember that show I used to do called the Wings Report? Well, guess what? Coming this December, get ready for a whole new season of the Wings Report with me, Timmy Flyersguy. I'll be doing coverage, pre-game coverage, of every Wings lacrosse game this season. Get ready, folks. Get ready to bang those boards, because the Wings Report will be making its return this December. That's right. The Wings Report will be making its return to the Timmy Flyersguy YouTube channel coming this December. Get ready. It's going to be action-packed. It's me, Timmy Flyersguy, and welcome to the latest edition of the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. I got some good news, and I got some bad news. But before we get to the bad news, I have some great news. A good friend of mine from the neighborhood, just recently got married. I'd like to say congratulations to my friend Amanda. She just recently got married. So congratulations to Mr. and Mrs. Robbins on their matrimony. Congratulations, Amanda. I'm so extremely happy for you. And you know, me and you, we go way back, and I just want to say you are a great friend. And an amazing person, and a beautiful lady, inside and out. And I think you are one of the nicest, kindest people I've ever met. And I'm very grateful for your friendship, and I'm truly grateful to have you in my life, and I'm truly happy for you. And it really warms my heart. You know, a good friend of mine is living her best life. I love you, Amanda. Friends forever. And I hope that you and your husband have many happy years together. Truly happy for that. Now, we get to the bad news. We get to some more good news. Before we get to the bad news, the Philadelphia Flyers played the Boston Bruins on Saturday. They beat the Bruins 2-1. Noah Casey, Jackson Cates got the goals for the Flyers, giving the Flyers a 2-1 victory. Great effort by the Flyers. Great goaltending by Sandstrom and Grossnick. Great game all around. Tortorella would be proud of the way this team played. Wade Allison did great. Stuck up for his teammate. Gotta give credit to Wade Allison. Hayden Hodgson dropped the gloves. Had himself a good scrap. All around great game on Flyers. They looked like a complete team. It was a very slow start, but once the Flyers started getting their skating legs, things started going well for them, and they looked pretty good. And they somehow had some pretty good hits in that game as well. Morgan Frost at the end of the game, epic shot block. By Frosty at the end of the game. It's amazing black shot homer for Frost. And Flyers pick up the 2-1 victory on Saturday. They got a game tomorrow night against the Buffalo Sabres in Buffalo at 7:30. I don't know when, if that game's going to be on TV. Most likely, I would say, it would probably be on the NHL Network. Probably the Sabres and Answers. We'll probably be doing the game. I would say it'll be on the NHL Network. And now we get to the bad news. Unfortunately, Sean Couturier will not be playing for a while due to a herniated disc in his back. Couturier is expected to be week to week. Maybe even more, so I'm not really sure about that. Carter Hart has been injured during practice. Cam Atkinson has also been injured during practice. And Carter Hart's hurt too. Carter Hart Nisimov will be hurt, is injured as well. Don't know how severe these other injuries are, but I'm hoping it's not serious. Unfortunately, Ryan Ellis will miss the whole season. It's looking like his career is over. He probably won't be back, but if he is, but Tortorella once said, if he does come back, that'll be a bonus for the Flyers team, but it doesn't look good for Ryan Ellis. It doesn't look good for Ellis. And I don't know what's going to happen with this team. But they're going to have to really work hard in putting this roster together, considering the severity of these injuries. So I'm not really sure what's going to happen with this team. But, you know, has not been easy for the Philadelphia Flyers. It has not been easy these past 2 years. It hasn't been, in my opinion. It's getting really frustrating that these guys keep getting hurt. And especially, it's such a bad omen that they're getting hurt before the preseason even gets started. It's really frustrating. There's something quite not right about this. I don't know if Comcast is too cheap to hire good doctors that can help these guys. I don't know what it is, but these injuries are just keep happening. It's like a pandemic of injuries on this team, and I just don't get it. It's perplexing to see these guys get hurt, and these guys are very young, and they're in the best shape of their lives, and they're still getting hurt. I mean, does anybody know why this keeps happening? I mean, this has been happening for about 2 years already. And the thing is, COVID hasn't even ravaged the team yet. And they're already getting injured. It's ridiculous. It's just mind-boggling to see how this is going. And in my opinion, we do have some guys that can step up for this team. The fact is, with all these injuries, it's going to affect the farm team as well. It's going to affect the Phantoms, and it's going to affect the Royals. So this is going to affect every team in the Flyers organization if people keep getting injured. Although Redding has some pretty good depth up front and in the back, so I don't know. Will you have any fans? I think they'll be okay. They may have to call Sandstrom up and have Sandstrom maybe take over for Hart, because I had no idea if Martin Jones can even really do anything. But I would go with Sandstrom as the starter if Carter Hart's injury isn't that bad. If Carter Hart's injury is really bad, I think that Sandstrom should get a shot. I mean, he's earned his shot. He's looked good last year. He looked good in preseason. So I would say if Carter Hart can't play and is hurt, let Sandstrom play. That way we have Sandstrom and Jones as the goaltending tandem. Jones can be the backup. Jones can be the backup. I think that Sandstrom has earned his spot. I really do. And I'd like to see what he contributes to this hockey team. So, if Sandstrom gets called up, then I would think Erickson and Grosnick would be the goaltending tandem for the Lehigh Valley Phantoms. Maybe Pat Nagel. I don't know. Because Pat Nagel had a good season for the Royals last year. He stood on his head. He played out of his mind for the Reading Royals. Logan Florell played out of his mind for the Reading Royals. So, I don't know how that's going to go. But I really think that Sandstrom will be the guy if Carter Hart's injury is as bad as we think it is. But I think this team will be okay, I think. Tortorella said it best, he said, we can't be that woe is me team. We have to be mentally tough. We have to be physically tough. But we have to be mentally tough as well, and that's what this team's problem is. This team is too soft. And Tortorella said it best. This team is soft. And Tortorella wants to make this team rock solid, is what I'm saying. And this team, for over the years, even when they were successful, they were too soft. That's just my opinion. They were too soft. They've had it easy for many, many, many years. Let's go accept. Except when Laviolette coached. That was a tough season. Laviolette worked those guys till their hands hurt. But to tell you the truth, they've had some coaches that were too lackadaisical. Elaine Vigneault was tough, but he wasn't tough enough. In my opinion. Dave Haxtell, he had too many excuses. And let me tell you, John Stevens, not even close. Although he did have a successful 08-07-08 season. I gotta give him that. And 08-09 is pretty good too, but Tortorella, I think he's the right guy for the job. He's a no-nonsense son of a bitch. And he is one tough son of a bitch too. And we need that. We need a guy like John Tortorella. We need a leader. A guy that will take this team to new heights. And I like John Tortorella. I like some of the stuff he said. He really pulls no punches. John Tortorella is one of the most brutally honest coaches in the NHL. And that's what we need. A coach that is brutally honest to the tee. And I'm happy to have John Tortorella here. At first, I gotta be honest with you. I didn't like John Tortorella. I thought he was a loud mouth. I thought he had a big mouth. And I thought he was crazy. And now when you hear him speak and hear him talk, he means what he says. He is convicted to what he says. When you look in his eyes, you believe what he says. You just look at him and say, this guy knows what he's talking about. It's like when Roman Reigns wanted to make a change in his career, he went to Paul Heyman. And Paul Heyman and John Tortorella remind me so much of each other. You see, Paul Heyman is a shrewd businessman. John Tortorella, he has that attitude as well. And when Roman Reigns wanted to be successful, Paul Heyman was the man that guided him. And I hope that John Tortorella can be the guy that guides these players. I hope that he'll be that guy, he'll be that person. When people say, I am a John Tortorella guy, they're going to mean that. And I really hope that this Flyers team doesn't get too comfortable. I hope that they don't use excuses. Because excuses will weigh you down and make you unsuccessful. And John Tortorella reminds me so much of me, anyway, because I am that guy that is no nonsense. I am that guy that screams at the TV when something doesn't go right. I am that guy that screams at the ref, screams at the players. I pull no punches, and I'm glad we got John Tortorella. A guy that thinks just like I think. And I like that. I like that. And John Tortorella, I want to say to you that I respect the hell out of you. And if I could play hockey, I would be honored to play on your team. I would be honored to get my ass kicked every single night doing practice drills. I would be honored to skate my ass off till I can't breathe. To skate my ass off till I throw up. Because if I could play hockey for the Philadelphia Flyers, I would bust my ass for this team. I would bleed for this team. Because I embody Flyers hockey. And I embody the vision of every single Philadelphia Flyers fan. And John Tortorella embodies the vision of every single Philadelphia Flyers fan. We're sick and tired of mediocrity. We're sick and tired of all the excuses, all the bullshit, and all the crap that we have to put up with. John Tortorella is the right man for the job. And I can't wait to see the John Tortorella show on that ice. It's time, Philly. Are you tired of the mediocrity? Are you tired of bullshit? Because I am. We all are. It's time for a change. And it's time to be tough. No more getting comfortable. No more Mr. Nice Guy. No more vacations. As far as I'm concerned, now that we have John Tortorella, and now that Timmy Flyersguy is back, the party's over. The party's over. And it's time to get to work. Time to lace up our boots, lace up our gloves, and lace up our skates. And it's time to get to work. It's time to kick some ass. And it's time to take some names. Because Flyers hockey, it needs to be great again. It has to be great again. And hopefully, John Tortorella will make Flyers hockey great again. Because honestly, the Wells Fargo Center has looked like a ghost town. There's nobody there. Hell, there's nobody even in the building. It looks like a ghost town. And we need to, I want my hockey team back. I want my hockey team back. And I want them to be better than ever. I want Flyers hockey. I don't want this mediocre bullshit hockey. I want real Flyers hockey. Alright, now that we got into that, I've been doing pretty well. Everything's been going great. I had a tough week a couple of weeks ago. On Friday, I was in a lot of pain. I had a bit of a muscle ache. In my legs, so I had to Saturday and Sunday. I was able to get over it on Monday. And I realized that sometimes when I have that muscle ache, it's good to not really take medication. I found it's not really good to be dependent on medication. And I learned that if you trust your body, you'll be okay. And I've been doing that. I've been feeling pretty good. I've been feeling okay. I haven't had any problems. And I'm feeling pretty good. I'm great and I'm healthy and I'm happy. I'm really excited for Flyers hockey. Even though we're having a lot of bad luck, I'm still very excited. And I will see you guys, hopefully I'll see you guys on Tuesday when the Flyers face off against the Buffalo Sabres. I'm doing pretty well, having a great few days. Doing pretty good getting ready for Tuesday's game. Flyers pregame report, get ready with the... We get to see a preview of tomorrow night's game on Flyers Free Game Report. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Flyers Free Game Report. See a preview of that on Flyers Free Game Report. As you just said, and you'll see what my thoughts are in the game coming up on Tuesday. I just want to thank you all for joining me here on the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. It's been great talking to you all. And there's a couple of people. Before I end this podcast, here are some channels that you guys should check out on YouTube. And here are some awesome people you should follow on Twitter and Instagram as well. Also, I can't wait for Flyers hockey. I can't wait for the next game on Tuesday. And I just gotta say, no matter what, I love being a fan. I'll always be a fan, and I'll always love this team, no matter what. And remember Philadelphia. We're in this together. We're thick and thin. We are Flyers fans, and we are all Flyers hockey. Thank you for joining me here on the Timmy Flyersguy podcast. It's been great talking to you all. I hope you all have a wonderfully great day. And remember, folks, always stay positive and avoid negativity, because negativity will weigh you down and it will distract you on your goals. So always stay positive and good things will come your way. Thank you, everybody, and have a great day. Much love and peace out, everybody.
Thank you.